I'm Tess Ngan Tian. I'm the president of Lotsa Pizza Franchise Systems Incorporated. I am a CPA by profession, and my ambition was really to become a partner. But when I got married with my husband, the whole thing turned around. And what happened was, my husband resigned from his corporate job. He didn't want an 8-to-5 work. He wanted to be on his own. He wanted to have more challenges. And so he decided to put up a business. And we started our first business in Mendiola, near the San Beda College. Siyempre, nag-umpisa kami mag-negosyo. Ano kami, we are corporate people, no? We started in the corporate world. Parang this was another field that we had to experience. So sabi namin, kaya ba nating mag-business? My husband is really the risk taker and the one who really guided us and gave us encouragement. Sabi niya, kung kaya natin mag-manage ng isang negosyo, because we were handling high positions where we were working, finance and administration, eh dyan din ang gagaling ang negosyo. Yan ang importanteng dapat malaman pag nenegosyo ka. Kasi ang nangyari, when we were in the corporate world, we were managing the company itself. But like we were the ones, the owners were just there, but we were the real managers of that company where we worked with. So parang, although ang difference lang noon was, it was not our business. So when we went into business, parang sabi namin, siguro pwede na natin gawin. Kasi we knew how to organize the people. We knew how to do HR and then come up with systems and procedures. We knew how to train people. Ang worry namin noon is, will the people accept our product? Matatanggap ba nila ang pizza namin? Are we going to be able to market it? Parang sabi namin, we are just new in the game and we were competing already with the big players at that time. Maraming na rin pizza players. Kaya lang sabi namin, we have to develop something na yung para sa atin lang. Talagang Filipino pizza. Na talagang magugustuhan ng lahat. So, when we were starting our first business in Mendiola, we were so worried, no? You know that on the first days where we were there, we would stay in the corner, pag may dumadaan, pumapalakpak kami. Ibig sabihin, may dumating na nagbumili ng produkto, may bumibili na. So lahat ng dumadaan, pinapalakpakan namin ang sarili namin. Ay naku, nakakapagbenta na pala tayo. Parang encourage kami, nasabi namin, sige lang, tuloy pala tayo, pwede. Ang talagang mahirap sa business namin is ang mga tao. I think anybody in the service industry would say that hiring, maintaining, and keeping people and making them compliant is always the hard thing. We can always cope up with other things like finance, management, but you know, we deal with a lot of people from our franchisees, from our customers, from our frontliners, and our employees as well. So, yan ang mahirap, how to be able to make them compliant and to really embrace the values that you have. My legacy now is no more engaging into the business for profit. I want to teach people. Parang ang ano ko na ngayon is, gusto ko na magturo. Gusto ko na tumulong na sila din maging successful in the future. Kasi I've earned my success already with all the awards I've had. It's now my time to give back to other people. So, later on naman, masabi nila, ay, successful na ako, maganda ng negosyo ko, kumita na ako, malaki na ako. We were able to expand and after a while, we decided to go into franchising. Boots and Linda Bartolome were our management consultants already before we went into franchising. And they were the ones actually who encouraged us to go into franchising because they said the product is ready, you have the systems, you are already organized. And so we started franchising in the year 2001. And from 1-2 franchises at that time, we now have 150 franchise outlets and 35 company-owned outlets and still expanding. I'd like to invite everybody to attend the AFI Expo coming this September 29th, October 1. And on stage, there will also be talks, open forum, Please join us. This will be a good learning experience for everyone. See you all.